Got it. Professor Monty, and I want to explain the doubling time formula to you. Real simple formula. The doubling time t is just ln of 2 divided by k, where k is whatever the growth rate is. Okay, so how long would it take $500 to double to $1,000 at 6% compounded continuously? Notice the amounts don't even play into it. We just say, oh, t equals ln of 2 divided by k. K is the growth rate. They say 6%. So t is ln of 2 divided by 0.06. And so t is approximately, we grab my calculator, ln of 2, close parentheses, divided by 0.06, about 11.55 years. And I'm done. Simple as that. Now, if that's all you wanted to learn, you can stop watching the video, go to another video, go to your homework, whatever you want to do. But let me explain why that's the case. In case you're like, well, where the 500, where the 1,000, oh, why does this formula work? Well, let's take a look. Why? All right, so I've got my general exponential formula, and you can either use n's or p's. Let's use n equals n sub 0 e to the kt, where n is the number of whatever I have at the end. N sub 0 is what I start with. And then I have E, K is the growth rate, T is the time. Okay, so let's see. I'm ending with $1,000. I'm starting with $500. And I've got E to the KT. Well, K is my growth rate. That's 6%. Oops. But I don't know T. I'm trying to find T. So what do? I divide both sides by 500. And notice the 1,000 divided by 500 is 2. It's always going to be a 2 if it doubles. If this was 5 million to 10 million, it doubled. If it was $1 to $2, it doubled. That's always going to be a t. And I've got e to the 0.06t. Remember, to solve that, I take the ln of both sides. So I've got ln of 2 equals ln cancels out e. Those are inverses. I just get the exponent, 0.06t. I divide by the 0.06, and I get t is ln of 2 divided by 0.06 is what we said right here for the problem. We know that's about 11.55 years. But that's why the formula works. It's always doubling, so it's always a 2. We're going to take the ln, so it's always ln of 2 on the top. The bottom is always the growth rate. Simple formula, remember it, it'll come in handy.